The iPhone X and other revamped Apple products were revealed during the company's annual event on Tuesday. So what do you need to know before you decide if you want to start throwing money at your screen? Let's break it down. First of all, can you believe it's the 10th anniversary of the iPhone? The iPhone X has been significantly redesigned to do away with the home button that has sat at the bottom of the device since it was first released in 2007. It also features a significantly larger screen, which reaches to the outer edge of each side of the phone. Apple CEO Tim Cook called the iPhone X the biggest leap forward since the original iPhone. It was announced after Apple also unveiled the updated iPhone 8 and iPhone 8 Plus. The iPhone 8 starts at $700 and features a new and improved camera and augmented reality support, among other updates. But the iPhone X will have many new features that aren't available in other iPhone models. Apple has developed a new technology called Face ID. It literally will allow you to unlock your phone with your face through a face scan. It will work with Apple Pay and several third-party apps. The true depth camera that enables Face ID also has more lighthearted uses. For example, Apple introduced Animojis, which are virtual avatars that turn people into the emoji that they use in text messages. People can record messages as a fox or a pig, for example, that move with them. And Apple has also partnered with Snapchat to offer new lenses that map to the face. Plus, Apple has developed a new charging product called AirPower, which allows people to wirelessly charge its new iPhones, as well as the Apple Watch and AirPods. But all this new technology won't come cheap. The iPhone X's price tag starts at an eye-popping $1,000. iPhone X will be available for pre-order on October 27th and to buy on November 3rd. It comes in space gray and silver. But that's not all Apple unveiled during the product event. There was also news about a revamped Apple Watch and an updated Apple TV. The updated Apple TV features an improved picture quality with 4K for higher resolution videos and high dynamic range for a wider range of colors. Apple Senior VP Eddie Q said that the company has struck deals with Hollywood studios and streaming services, like Netflix and Amazon, to bring their library of 4K movies and TV shows to iTunes. Titles in 4K will cost the same price as titles sold in HD. However, the new 4K capabilities will only work for customers who have purchased television sets with those capabilities, a market that is still small. Other updates include a revamped TV app that will place emphasis on live sports by showing games along with their score and time left. The revamped app will also be available on iPad and iPhone. Plus, the app will become available in more countries, including Canada and Australia, after its US-only launch last year. For more on the Apple product event, check out THR.com, and Apple fans have got to hear from you. Will you be splurging on the new iPhone X? Be sure to let me know in the comments. I'm Tiffany Taylor for The Hollywood Reporter News. This episode of The Hollywood Reporter News is brought to you by American Airlines, Hollywood's favorite airline.